bring me my wood, you peasant.
Harry, don't make me put you in a cage.
HodgePodge. I like your beaver. I really like your beaver.
Come on, Harry. I keep telling you to keep your wood clean. We've got ants again.
But Robert, I was wanting this wood to spalt. It was sitting out in the dirt.
Oh. I guess that's forgivable. I understand, Harry.
What's the matter? You got ants in your pants?
Here I'm mounting the blank between centers just so I can true up the face so I can add a faceplate. My plan with this blank was to make a natural edge platter. Obviously the blank is a little big for a platter. At one point I thought of trying to cut the blank in half, however I ended up just wasting a lot of the wood.
Robert, it's not a waste of wood. This beaver was stuffed with it.
Yeah.
He was ridiculous, Robert. Save a horse, ride a Powermatic.
When turning an ingrain bowl, you often want to go from the inside of the bowl to the rim when cutting. However, to get the final thickness at the rim, I found it much easier to go from the rim to the inside as I'm doing here. I ended up getting a fairly decent cut, so I kept doing it that way. See this, Harry? That's why you don't wear pockets while you're turning wood.
Hey, I thought you were saving that for me for later for a snack. Come on, guys. You know you want to buy some Starbond. I've got a coupon code in the description below for 15% off.
While taking the piece off the lathe, I noticed that the curvature in the inside of the bowl seemed to go pretty deep and even past the chuck into the tenon. Here I'm checking with calipers and realizing that my new design has to have a foot, otherwise it'll be a funnel.